The pass is unique way all weekend, much like past weekends. St. Lucians were confined to their homes as a measure to curb COVID transmission. And most have been content to comply, understanding the situation. However, the emergence of videos on Sunday showing cruise tourists moving about the country, sightseeing and enjoying some time at the beach has sparked outrage among members of the public. Many are disappointed with what they say seems like a disparity between visitors and locals when it comes to adherence of the protocols.
I'm not against the tourists coming in. I'm not against them walking around. What I am against is St. Lucians are being treated like criminals. We are on lockdown. The curfew, Sunday to Sunday is okay. But you see that whole day thing? On a Sunday, it's not good. We need to go to church. Church on TV, that's not church yet.
I'm disappointed in the tourists walking about. If they have lockdown for us, they're supposed to have lockdown for tourists because it's just a color of people. You understand? And the dogs lockdown, cat lockdown, tourists are supposed to be locked down too. So I'm disappointed.
This woman, however, has condemned what she says is the disrespectful language hurled at the visitors by the individual who captured video of tourists disembarking a bus for a bathroom break in the community of Ancillary.
The people could understand the language. We St. Lucians need to know what we want for ourselves. You understand? If we want tourists or we don't want tourists. They're talking about everything is not good, everything is hard, everything is hard. If I don't have a problem in there thinking, well, the tourists have no movement, but you're not swaying and you're cursing and you're thinking, and the people understand all what you are saying. You're making the people feel uncomfortable. What kind of experience you giving the people there when you curse and do all that? You understand? I couldn't expect the event, but I find it's very ignorant and that's very stupid of the guy to say these kind of things.
Mere hours after the video surfaced, the Ministry of Tourism and the St. Lucia Tourism Authority issued a press release on the matter explaining that though the government maintains a position that protocols should apply to visitors and nations alike, in some cases, exceptions are made for businesses and activities that are critical for the growth of the country's economy. Also, that the cruise passengers are required to meet a number of requirements before disembarking, including being fully vaccinated. The tourism minister, Dr. Ernest Hilaire, is quoted in the press release explaining the necessity for cruise tourism operations to not be interrupted, as this could, quote, result in a loss of service to the destination and thereby negatively impact the industry and its many dependents locally, end quote. But that explanation did not fly with this member of the public.
That's a very poor excuse on behalf of Hilaire, because when the former prime minister said lockdown 3 o'clock on a Sunday, he had to make a comment and said he had to, when he go to family meet, lunch, 3 o'clock, he wouldn't be able to leave and reach home for 3 o'clock. Now they have it 24/7. Every Sunday is a lockdown. I'm very disappointed in his comment.
In the statement from the tourism officials, the public is called upon to participate actively and responsibly in the recovery of livelihoods and the fight against COVID-19, to get vaccinated and to be good ambassadors for the destination by treating each other with dignity and respect. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.